Hi everyone, welcome back. In the previous two videos on vectors, we did the basics. We first saw what vectors are, where are they used, then we did some basic operations on vectors like vector addition, subtraction. In the second video, we saw what vector multiplication is, the two types of vector multiplication, dot product and cross product. Now let's come to the problems. In this video, we will first do some basic questions and then we will define what is the equation of a line, what is the equation of a plane using the vectors. Let's come to the examples. In the first example, we are asked to find the unit vector u that makes an angle of pi by 6 with the x-axis. So let's first draw the figure. So we've taken the two axes. Let's take the unit vector u. We are given it makes an angle of pi by 6 with the x-axis. If we take a to be the unit vector's component along the x-axis and b to be its component along the y-axis, then from the triangle, we have cos of pi by 6 is equal to the base, which is a, upon the hypotenuse, which is 1 because you are given a unit vector. So we have a is nothing but cos of pi by 6. You know that cos of pi by 6 will be root 3 by 2. And what is sine of pi by 6? Sine of pi by 6 be nothing but perpendicular upon hypotenuse, which means b upon 1. This gives us b is equal to sine of pi by 6, which is half. So what does our unit vector u become? Unit vector u will be nothing but ai plus bj. You know that I and j are unit vectors along the x and y axis. Put the values of a and b, you get root 3 by 2i plus half j. Now, if you want to see whether this is a unit vector or not, you can find the modulus of this, which will be nothing but square of our a, that is 3 by 4, and add square of b, which will be 1 by 4. So we get 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4, which gives us 1. You see that it is a unit vector. So we have found the unit vector u, which was asked. In the second question, we are given a vector v, 2i plus 2j plus k, and we have to find the unit vector in its direction. Now, this is a direct question. You know that the unit vector v in the direction of vector v will be nothing but vector v divided by its modulus. Now, what is the modulus of v? That is nothing but root of 2 square plus 2 square plus 1 square. We've taken the coefficients. So here you know that this is 1. So we have 2 square plus 2 square plus 1 square, which is nothing but root of 9, and that gives us 3. So our unit vector v will be nothing but the vector 2i plus 2j plus k divided by its modulus 3. You can write it as 2 by 3i plus 2 by 3j plus 1 by 3k. So this is the unit vector in the direction of v. Let's come to question number 3. Here we are given two vectors a and b. A is 3i plus 6j. B is half I plus j. We have to find whether a and b are in the same direction or not. To find the direction, we will find the unit vectors along a and b. Unit vector a would be nothing but the vector a divided by its magnitude. as A is given to be 3i plus 6j, and its magnitude will be root of 3 square plus 6 square. This gives us 3i plus 6j divided by root of 45, which is nothing but 3 root of 5. On simplifying, we get the unit vector as I by root 5 plus 2j by root of 5. So we have the unit vector along A. Let's find the unit vector along B. That would be vector B divided by its magnitude. Vector B is half I plus j divided by its magnitude, which will be half square plus 1 square. Simplify, we will get half I plus j divided by root 5 upon 2. Now, this gives us the unit vector I upon root 5 plus 2j upon root 5. You can see both the unit vectors along A and B are the same, which means that A and B are in the same direction. So you just saw that the direction of A and B is the same. I want you to see one more thing. Let's find the angle between the two vectors. For that we use the formula A dot B is equal to modulus of A modulus of B cos of theta. A, you know, is 3i plus 6j, and B is half I plus j. Modulus you had just found of A was 3 root 5. Modulus of B we had found will be root of 5 by 2 cos of theta. Left hand side is nothing but 3 by 2 plus 6. We've taken the dot product of the two vectors. And right hand side is 15 by 2 cos of theta. Now left hand side is also 15 by 2. Right hand side is 15 by 2 cos of theta. This gives us cos of theta is equal to 1, and which implies theta is equal to 0. Now, as theta is 0, what does it tell us? It tells us that the angle between the two vectors is 0. Now, look at the two vectors. Your vector A is nothing but 3i plus 6j, and that is nothing but 6 times your half I plus j. And what is half I plus j? That is b. So 6b. So what do we get? We have A is nothing but 6b. If you look at your vectors A and B, A is nothing but 6 times of B. If this is my B, our A is still here. The vector A is 6 times B. The angle between them is 0, and they both are in the same direction. Let's come to question number 4. We are given two vectors A and B. A is 2i minus j plus 2k, and B is I minus j minus k. We have to find the scalar component of A in the direction of B. Another word for scalar component is projection of A along B or in the direction of B. So here we will use the formula projection of A in the direction of B is nothing but A dot B upon mod of B whole square into the vector B. So what is A? A is 2i minus j plus 2k. Dot product with B which is I minus j minus k, the vector b divided by modulus of b whole square. So what is the modulus? It is 1 square plus minus 1 square plus minus 1 square whole square. This gives us, if you take the dot product, we will get 2 plus 1 minus 2 into the vector b, which is I minus j minus k divided by 3. As you get root of 3 as your modulus b, and when we take the whole square, we get 3. So what is our projection of A in the direction of B? It is nothing but I minus j minus k divided by 3. You can even write it as I by 3 minus j by 3 minus k by 3. Before we proceed to other questions, let's look at the equation of a line and equation of a plane. So the vector equation of a line through a point P0, which has coordinates x0, y0, z0, and parallel to a vector v, is given by rt is equal to r0 plus dv, where t value is in the range minus infinity to infinity. Rt is the position vector of point P and r0 of P0. We can also write the equation of the line through the point x0, y0, z0 and parallel to the vector v, v1i plus v2j plus v3k, as x is equal to x0 plus v1t, y is equal to y0 plus v2t, and z is equal to z0 plus v3t, where t is again in the range minus infinity to infinity. And the equation of a plane which passes through a point p0, x0, y0, z0, and normal to the vector n, which is given as ai plus bj plus ck, has two forms. First, the vector form, where it is the dot product of the vector n and p0, p, and is equal to 0. And the second is the component form, where we have the equation as ax minus x0 plus by minus y0 plus c, z minus z0 is equal to 0. So let's come to this question, question number 5. We have to write the equation of a line passing through the point 1, 3, minus 9 and parallel with the vector v, which is 3i minus 4j plus 4k. Now, our point x0, y0, z0 through which the line is passing is given as 1, 3, minus 9 and v1, v2, v3 are 3 minus 4, 4. These v1, v2, v3 we get from here. So the equation of the line is x is equal to x0 plus v1t, y is equal to y0 plus v2t, and z is equal to z0 plus v3t. This gives us x is equal to 1 plus 3t, y is equal to 3 minus 4t, and z is equal to minus 9 plus 4t, where our t is in the range minus infinity to infinity. So this is the equation of the line. Let's come to question number 6. Here we are asked to write the equation of a plane passing through a point 2, 1, minus 1 and normal to the vector 2i minus 3j plus 4k. You have already seen we have two forms. One is the vector form and the other is the component form. Now, both the forms can be used and we'll get the same answer. Let's start with the component form. You are given that the plane passes through the point 2, 1, minus 1, which means our x0, y0, z0 is 2, 1, minus 1. And as the vector n is 2i minus 3j plus 4k. So our a, b, c are 2 minus 3, 4. In the component form, the equation is a x minus x naught plus b y minus y naught plus c z minus z naught is equal to 0. Let's substitute the values of a, b, c and x naught, y naught, z naught. A is 2, x minus x naught is also 2, b value is minus 3, y naught is 1, c is 4, z minus z naught is minus 1. So this becomes z plus 1 is equal to 0. Simplify, your equation will be 2x minus 3y plus 4z is equal to minus 3. Now, let's try the vector form. In vector form, you know the equation is vector n dot p naught p is equal to 0. For us, vector n is given to be 2i minus 3j plus 4k, and p is the point x, y, z. P naught is the point x naught, y naught, z naught. So, what will be p naught p? It would be coordinates of p minus the coordinates of p naught. This I've already explained in the previous video. So, here this means x minus x naught I plus y minus y naught j plus z minus z naught k is the vector p naught p. Put the values of x naught, y naught, z naught, we'll get x minus, what was x naught? X naught was 2 I plus y minus y naught, y naught was 1, j plus z minus z naught, which was minus 1 k. So this is our p naught p, the vector. N is nothing but 2i minus 3j plus 4k dot x minus 2i plus y minus 1j plus z plus 1k is equal to 0. Take the dot product, you will get 2 x minus 2 minus 3 y minus 1 plus 4 z plus 1 is equal to 0. On simplifying, we'll again get 2x minus 3y plus 4z is equal to minus 3. You can see that these two equations are same. So, whether we use the component form or the vector form, we will get the same answer. Let's come to question number 7. Here we are given 3 points PQR. We have to find the area formed by the triangle PQR and to find the unit vector which is perpendicular to the plane of PQR. Now, let's say our triangle is PQR. Write 2 vectors which form the adjacent sides of the triangle. Here, we will form the 2 vectors PQ and PR. You can see PQ and PR form the adjacent sides of the triangle. What is the vector PQ? You know, from the coordinates of Q, we will subtract the coordinates of P. This will give us the vector 2 minus 1i plus 1 minus of minus 1, so that becomes plus 1j plus minus 1 minus 2. Okay. Now, on simplifying, we'll get I plus 2j minus 3k. Let's write the vector PR. Now, PR we'll get when we subtract the coefficients of P from R. Now, this will give us minus 1 minus 1i plus 2 minus of minus 1, which is plus 1j plus 1 minus 2k. This will give us minus 2i plus 3j minus k. Now we will find the area of the triangle. So area of the triangle PQR will be nothing but half modulus of PQ cross PR, which means we need to find the cross product. Now, cross product of PQ and PR will be, from the determinant IJK, write the coefficients of PQ, which are 1, 2, minus 3, and PR, which are minus 2, 3, minus 1. Open the determinant, we will get I, and in this determinant 2, minus 3, 3, minus 1, minus j, 1, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, plus k, 1, 2, minus 2, 3. This will give us minus 2 plus 9i, and this will be minus of minus 1 minus 6j, and third will be 3 plus minus 4, which is plus 4. So we get 7i plus 7j plus 7k as a vector PQ cross PR. Now, the area will be half modulus of this, which is 7 square, 7 square, 7 square. This is nothing but half. We have 7 root of 3 units. Now, the next which we had to find was the unit vector which is perpendicular to the plane of PQR. So, the unit vector perpendicular to the plane of PQR is nothing but 7i plus 7j plus 7k divided by its magnitude 7 root 3, and this is nothing but 1 by root 3 I plus j plus k. So this gives us the unit vector. Let's come to the last question. Here we are given three vectors A, B, C. We have to find which are the ones which are parallel and which are the ones which are perpendicular. You already know, given any vector U and V, if their dot product is 0, it implies they are perpendicular, And if their cross product is zero, this implies they are parallel. Let's find the dot product. You will see that the dot product of A and B will come out to be minus 6. The dot product of B and C will be nothing but 18. And the dot product of A and C will be minus 81. You see that the dot products are not zero. This is not zero. This is not zero. This is not zero. Now this shows that none of them are perpendicular to the other vector. Now let's check whether they are parallel or not. Now, if we find the cross product of A and C, you will see that the cross product will give us a zero vector. Let's write the coefficients of A, 5, minus 1, 1, and the coefficients of C, minus 15, 3, minus 3. Open this up, you will get I, 3, minus 3, minus J, minus 15, plus 15, plus K, 15, minus 15. You get a zero vector. A and C are parallel. But other cross products will not be zero. So A cross B will not be equal to zero. This you can do yourself. And B cross C will also not be equal to zero. So the only vectors which are parallel are A and C. Thank you for watching. The next topic will be on matrices. You can check my website profpreetivajpayee.com for detailed notes, exercises for practice.